I'ma take a drive and end up in the wrong block. Put me in a party, comes out, that's the wrong car. Got an ego to hit a condor, long shot. Coming like you know me, really? Do you? Slide like a tootsie, I go hootu. I put a hole in your one with a tutu. Watch the story change from a nose to a new you. Great like I'm Gatsby, pace for the Gatsby. Race like a track meet, face like I'm backstreet. Yeah. Pretty boy, got pretty toys. They owe that art, I'm petty boy.
All you pretty boys, white toy soldier. I want your green like botany. My God, I'm a loose cannon at a bang on, I'm so sodomy. No mince words, no apostrophes, no apologies, no sorry now. Remember when I ain't have a Ford, now the time's rolling. Sorry now,
is this?
That's all I hear when they rap.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free good idea. You can also get a light bulb with it for a limited time only. What's going on, YouTube? It's Noxil, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, man, it's going to be a good day. It's going to be a good day. Do you know why? Because we have more NF on deck. Now, I pay attention, guys. I know I get a lot of comments on my videos now, but let me tell you, I read each and every single one of them. And I try to respond to as much as I can. And if I can't respond, guys, just know that it's still been read. So please keep posting, keep suggesting. But since we did our intro 3 reaction, we have now had overwhelming recommendations for me to go further back into Nate's discography and to check out Mansion. But before we go any further, guys, I want to give a quick shout out to a brand new series that I just released. This was inspired by people like NF, by other great artists that we've reacted to. I wanted to dig back into the roots of hip hop, into the roots of MCing, and bring you something where hip hop first started, when it was about two MCs going back and forth, trying to one-up each other. It's called Battle Sessions. I just played it in the intro. If you guys are interested in checking that out, it's a really cool celebration of the culture. So go check that one. Link below. All right. NF time. You know, I don't really know what to say. I mean, intro 3 had just such great, intricate storytelling, and you guys are telling me that this one is even better, and this one sets the stage for everything that happened in intro 3. So I'm looking forward to seeing what this is about. So Nate, it's your time to shine, man. Step back up to the plate. Let's see what you got.
Insidious is blind inception. What's reality with
one line in? One line in and I have to stop. Insidious is blind inception. Wow, that's a crazy line right there. Already the poetry and the depth to that. You know, it's insidious. It's evil by nature. Talking about inception, creeping up into your mind, into your subconscious, taking over when you're not even paying attention, when you're not aware of it. And we've got the pianos again. He is a master with the piano production. Another piano-inspired track. I'm ready for this.
Insidious is blind inception. What's reality with all these questions? Feels like I missed my alarm and slept in. Broken legs, but I chase perfection. These walls are my blank expression. My mind is a home I'm trapped in, and it's lonely inside this mansion.
Wow, I love the control of her voice. It's so smooth, but it's hollow and haunting. This home I'm trapped in. Like, and then she even whispers to bring you in further. That's nice, man. It's some of those lines, again, just bars for a singer right there. Did NF write this or did she write this? I'm not sure, actually, but still, man, I love it. It just sets it all up perfectly, talking about broken legs, but still I chase perfection. How can you chase anything with broken legs? Saying that, you know, he's already crippled. Nate's already crippled, but still, even though that he's crippled, even though he's a broken person, he's still chasing perfection and chasing this plateau. Man, that's crazy deep. And then there was a line about reality, but I'll have to catch it on the next hook around, because that was crazy, talking about like your subjective thoughts and what is real versus what goes on in your head. More inception type of stuff going on. Oh, I love it. I love this already. He's not even rapping yet. Man.
Yo, my mind is a house with walls covered in lyrics. They're all over the place. A song's in a mirror. It's written all over the floors, all over the chairs. And you get the uncut version of life when I go downstairs.
Wow.
That's where I write when I'm in a bad place. I need to...
You get the uncut version of life when I go downstairs. He's talking about his house, his mansion that he lives in. The walls, even the mirrors, are all covered in lyrics. And just think about the way that those lyrics have been placed. Like, he's not going up the stairs for the uncut version. The uncut meaning, you know, like the unedited, the unfiltered, just all of the raw emotions and experiences and lyrics that he's going through. Like, you go downstairs for that. Like, you're going down, right? Think about that symbolism, down versus up. That's cool.
The chairs, and you get the uncut version of life when I go downstairs. That's where I write when I'm in a bad place and need to release and let out the version of NF you don't want to see. I put holes in the walls with both of my fists till they bleed. You might get a glimpse of how I cope with all this anger in me. Physically abused.
I put holes in these walls with both my fists till they bleed. Now, he's just painted this picture of his mind in this house, in the lyrics, and where everything lives. So he's literally putting holes in the walls via his anger, but also he's putting holes in his mind, right? Because anything that he does to his house, anything that happens, affects him directly. Wow. I mean, the symbolism here and just the greater metaphor of the song with Mansion already, man. I mean, we're not even a minute into this. I'm amazed. I thought intro 3 was just some next level storytelling and introspection, but this, man, here we go.
I get a glimpse of how I cope with all this anger in me. Physically abused. Now that's the room that I don't want to be in. That picture ain't blurry at all. I just don't.
Wow, physically abused. Now that's a room I don't want to be in. And that's raw. And did you guys hear the ad-lib sound in the background? It was almost like a scream or kind of like a high-pitched siren. That was really cool. And then it just echoed out very hauntingly. Listen to this. This is
abused. Now that's the room that I don't want to be in. That picture ain't blurry at all. I just don't want to see it. And these walls ain't blank. I just think I don't want to see them. But why not? I'm in here, so I might as well read. I got to thank you for this anger.
So he's talking about abuse. Right. And you guys have told me that he was abused, and it was his mom's boyfriend, wasn't it? It wasn't his father. It was his mom's boyfriend who abused him. So now he's addressing it. And all of the abuse and him venting and outletting is all written on the walls. And that image isn't blurred. Like, he doesn't want to see these things. He doesn't want to read them. But I'm in here right now, so I might as well talk about it. Wow.
That I carry around. Wish I could take a man.
I'm kind of speechless, honestly, because we're now diving into the depths of his mind and dealing with some very tough, very personal issues. But instead of just talking about those issues on a song, to come up with this greater concept and this greater metaphor of it all happening within his house, and then everything connects in that way, that's crazy. That's crazy.
You for this anger that I carry around. No. Wish I could take a match and burn this whole room to the ground. Matter of fact, I think I'm gonna burn this room right. Somehow this memory for some reason just won't come down. Put me in the corner so you could see the fear in my eyes. Then took me downstairs and beat me till I screamed and I cried.
Man.
Congratulations, you'll always have a room in my mind. But I'ma keep the door shut and lock the lyrics inside.
Other thing that was cool, talking about his delivery, and this is something that goes underappreciated with Nate. He's so good with his delivery. And the first half of that verse, we didn't have the drums kick in. We didn't have a lot of percussion, right? And the way he was rapping, he was a lot smoother with it. He was kind of down with his voice. And then once the drums and percussion came in, he got a lot more aggressive. And he started yelling and he was really attacking the microphone, and his vocal presence just fills the room. So well, something so underappreciated about Nate that you don't really notice is how many different changes, not only to the flow, but also to his cadence and what he's doing. And then those lines, man, talking about trying to burn that room down, but he can't. But even though he tries to ignore it, even though he tries to avoid, you know, the abuse that he went through and that he doesn't want to talk about it, it's always going to be there as a room in his mind. But he's going to lock it away and put it away for now. Hard.
Shut and lock the lyrics inside.
Insidious as blind inception. What's reality with all these questions?
I love this hook. That's it. What's reality with all these questions? All these questions that I'm asking myself, like, what is reality? Because he's saying, you know, I live so much in my mind, but here is the world. But what is reality to me? And that is a question in and of itself.
Questions, feels like I missed my alarm and slept in. Broken legs, but I changed.
Also, sorry to keep pausing, but feels like I missed my alarm and slept in. Talking about Inception and sort of the cinematic feel that Nate has to a lot of his tracks. I think he was actually inspired by the movie Inception. He has said this in an interview before. But also, the inception of the mind, and he slept in. So kind of like he's dreaming almost, right? Like, what is real and what isn't, and what is a dream? And that's why he's chosen the alarm and slept in imagery.
I slept in broken legs, but I chase perfection. These walls are my blank expression. My mind is a home I'm trapped in, and it's lonely inside this mansion. Inside this mansion.
Yo, my mind is a house with walls covered in pain. See, my problem is I don't fix things, I just try to repaint. Cover them up like it never happened.
Yo, my mind is a house with walls covered in pain. And see, on the first verse he said, my mind is a house with walls covered in lyrics, and now we're covered in pain. Wow, I love that connection and that symmetry, like starting both verses with those lines. But then we dive into a different aspect now, in a different shell of Nate.
Fix things, I just try to repaint. Cover them up like it never happened. Say I wish I could change. Are you confused? Come upstairs and I'll show you what I mean.
Man, I don't fix things, I just repaint. Like, just cover it up. You know when you get blemishes on a wall and marks? Instead of trying to wipe them out, you just throw a new coat of paint over it and then act like it's not there. But it's still there underneath of the surface. Think about that. His pain and his anguish is still there underneath of the surface, no matter what he does with his music and with his lyrics.
Could change. Are you confused? Come upstairs and I'll show you what I mean. This room full of regrets just keeps getting fuller, it seems. Moment I walk into, it's the same moment that I want to leave. I get sick to my stomach every time I look at these things. But it's hard to look past. When this is the room where I sleep, I look around, one of the worst things I wrote on these walls was the moment I realized that I was losing my mind. One of the first things I wrote was I wish I would have called. But I should just stop now, we ain't got enough room in this song. And I regret the fact that I...
Wow. So he's sitting in the room of no regrets, and he's regretting not speaking to his mom when he knew that she was dying. And we went through How Could You Leave Us. And he says here, like, that's just way too much to unpack in this song. Now, did this come out before or after How You Could Leave Us? I feel like this has to be before. Because How Could You Leave Us is just such a deep song and a deep dive into that whole relationship with his mother. But this is like foreshadowing. And this is what he does. He connects so many of his songs and his discographies together. It's nice. It's a nice way just to keep symmetry going throughout his albums. And so the fans can constantly connect the story.
I would have called, but I should just stop now. We ain't got enough room in this song. And I regret the fact that I struggle trying to find who I am. And I lie to myself and say I do the best that I can. Shrug it off like it ain't nothing, like it's out of my head. And get ticked off whenever I see it affecting my plans. And I regret watching these trust issues eat me alive. And at the rate I'm going, I'll probably still be there when I die. Congratulations, you'll always have a room in my mind. The question is, will I ever clean the walls off inside?
Wow. And then not only did he have symmetry at the beginning of the verse, but towards the end. Congratulations, you always have a room in my mind. Like talking about the pain that he went through and getting abused, and now talking about the regrets that he has. And he has so many trust issues now as a result of these abusive relationships with his mom, with his mom's boyfriend as well. Just so many things that he's unpacking and letting out emotionally, but they're all still there. Even though he's letting it out on these tracks, they're still there with him, and you never truly get rid of them.
Insidious as blind inception. What's real?
Are we in like a psychology class right now? I feel like we are. This is psych 101. Professor Knox now in session.
Insidious as blind inception. What's reality with all these questions? Feels like I missed my alarm and slept in. Slept in broken legs, but I chase perfection. These walls are my blank expression. My mind is a home I'm trapped in, and it's only inside.
It's like he's used this before when he's taken instruments and they sound kind of drowned out, and he's just changed the frequency on them. And Drake does this a lot too with his beats, except this time instead of taking like percussion and drowning out drums, so it's like almost lo-fi in a way, it sounds like the piano and the keys along this are just drowned out as well. Just adds to the sort of haunting effect of all the music. There's a lot of reverb laced on top of this stuff, and it's echoing out too way back in the mix. It's cool.
This mansion. inside this mansion.
So this part of my house, no one's been in it for years. I built a safe room and I won't let no one in there. Cause if I do, there's a chance that they might disappear and not come back. And I admit, I am emotionally scared to let anyone inside. So I just leave my doors locked. You might get other doors to open up, but this door's not. Cause I don't want you to have the opportunity to hurt me. And I'll be the only person that I can blame when you desert me. I'm buried.
I don't want you to have the opportunity to hurt me. I'll be the only person to blame when you desert me. Wow. And he's talked about this in some of his other songs too. Like, you know, because of his insecurities, because of his relationships, like he's afraid now to love and to let someone else in. And how can you love someone if you don't truly love yourself and you have all these issues with yourself at the same time? And the second that you leave yourself vulnerable and you let your walls down to someone else, you give them the opportunity to hurt you. And if you've been through enough hurt and enough pain, you don't want to get hurt again. So you never put yourself out there. You never give yourself a chance to love and to be loved. And that introspection from Nate is crazy. And he's talking about this room, obviously, where there's even more to it. Like even more than he doesn't say, because he puts so much out into these tracks and he just bears it open for all to witness. But yet what he's implying here is that there's still inner thoughts and inner things that he still keeps inside and he keeps locked in this room that he doesn't even share with us.
To hurt me, and I'll be the only person that I can blame when you desert me. I'm barricaded inside, so stop knocking. I'm
not love that kick, man.
Door, so stop knocking, stop knocking. I'm trapped here. God keeps saying I'm not locked. I chose this. I am lost in my own conscience. I know they shouldn't.
Wow. I chose this. I'm trapped here. God keeps saying I'm not locked in. Listen to his aggression and his passion in his voice. But how profound is that too? Like, he's thinking that he's locked in this room, but he's not really locked in. Can you truly be locked in the room if you're the one who locked yourself in it? He's the one that chose this. He built this room. He put himself in there. He doesn't have to be in there.
In the world out ain't solving the problem, but I didn't build this house because I thought it would solve them. I built it because I thought that it was safer in there, but it's not. I'm not the only thing that's living in here. Fear came to my house years ago. I let him in. Maybe that's a problem because I've been dealing with this ever since. I thought that he would leave, but it's obvious he never did. He must have picked a room and got comfortable and settled in.
Wow.
Now I'm in a position.
Wow. Well, that just connects everything to intro three right there. You know, fear came in years ago and I let him in. He must have got comfortable and settled in. Fear entered his mind, and he's always been dealing with fear, and he deals with fear, and he tries to take him out back, and he tries to bury him and get rid of that emotion on intro three. Oh my God, what an amazing connection, though, like to bring those two together and connect that, because he sets this up here in Mansion for then intro three to happen with fear, because fear is here now, and fear is something that he's dealing with in his own house, and it's like he's a stranger, but he's also not a stranger, because fear is a part of him. That duality is crazy.
Let's either sit here and let him win or put him back outside where it came from, but I never can. Because in order to do that, I'd have to open the doors. Is that me or the fear talking? I don't know anymore.
What a profound set of lines there to end that verse. You know, to get rid of him, I'd have to open the doors. Is that me or the fear talking? I don't know anymore. Because he's afraid to open the doors. Like, what is himself outside of fear? And what is himself trapped by fear? Man, this is like watching the movie Inception, but in audio form. Just the depths to the mind and the subconscious and what's going on here is crazy. And this electric guitar is nice. Oh, those harmonies.
Inside this mansion.
Wow. Let me tell you something. There is a difference between being a rapper and being an MC. An MC who lives it. An MC who takes it as a way of life. An MC who is a master at storytelling. And Nate, I mean, this is a masterclass in storytelling and in emceeing. I mean, the amount of symbolism on this, the metaphors, but at the same time, being able to talk about such personal issues and raw feelings and put it into a song so that the whole thing connects. And then to have such a profound hook, but also while it's profound, it's catchy. You want to sing along to it, and it has replay value. I mean, this is just the total package of a song. Nate, you were Knoxville certified. So hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, be sure to smash that like button. Comment down below any other NF songs you want to see me do, or if there's other artists you want to see me check out. I try to read all of your comments, guys. I respond to as much as I can, so please keep commenting and keep posting. Also, don't forget to subscribe, notifications on, so that we can keep growing, keep building the buzz, and keep doing this. The more that you comment, like, and subscribe, the more it bumps us up in the algorithms and lets us get seen by other people who might like channels like this very one. Also, this is your reminder, if you want to support me and the channel and what we're doing so we can keep making more videos, go check out my Patreon below, go check out my new merchandise, or even check out the music. All of it helps me and just goes so much further than you guys think. Appreciate you guys. You know I love you. This is your reminder to stay positive and to stay safe. It's a crazy world out there, but just know you were never, ever alone. I love this community. It's Knox Hill, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'm out.
Sometimes I feel like I'm locked up. They got me in this box with them cuffs trying to label me and take my mouth shut. But I spit it at my prime, Amazon with my delivery, returning what was sent for me. These rappers writing songs, I'm out here writing symphonies. I put my pain into this mic, I'm spilling my soliloquy. R.P. my man Dilla, I'm in Dela in this prison. Now you see me for my vision, been a minute I've been spitting. I've been wishing for a difference, I've been trying to close the distance, but it feels like the same old story. High hope silver, I'm in my glory. I'm that ranger, I've been lonely.